And let us say that you kind of know certain, let us say, physical model elements or physical data elements in the retail world from a warehouse perspective, you know, things like maybe SKU or, you know, invoice number or so on and so on, right? How can you easily associate that with a business term as far as possible automatically?
So when you say business term, what do you mean by that?
So that comes in from what you would actually have in a particular environment as a repo, which is a business glossary, right? So business glossary is really terms which are English definitions for things, or terminologies which are running as a part of the industry, right?
Yes.
So you can assume that things like, you know, category, description or item description. You could use SKU, but, you know, you would call it a stock keeping unit and all of that. So typically, you know, in good governance environments, there is a business vocabulary which is established by the company, right? Yes. Now, the business vocabularies primarily are blocked or locked in into repositories which are called as glossaries or business glossaries, right? And business glossaries typically would have, I would say, three aspects to it, right? So is that one repository can be something which is shipped by us as Genpact as a company, saying that, hey, this is my meta model and this is my glossary which I'm shipping with my meta model, which means the factory shipped glossaries. The second is that the client might want to import certain glossaries which are from an industry, right? Like, example, let's say that there is some things which you use from Microsoft's common business model, or let's say some things from schema.org, or, you know, any other retail standard, right? So you might want to import that. And the third one, which the client typically uses, is their own version, where they kind of harmonize what might be factory shipped by a particular vendor, harmonize it with an industry standard and say, okay, you know, in Target or Walmart, right? SKU means this, right? But it is called so-and-so by Genpact, but and it is called so-and-so as Genpact as the vendor, it is called so-and-so in this industry, you know, and so on and so forth, right? So what we are looking at is the moment the physical metadata comes in, right? May it be you looking up in our DBMS, may it be you looking up a warehouse model, a dimensional warehouse model, may it be a scenario where you're looking up, let us say, attributions in a JSON store. And see, that spread is up to you on how broad you want to spread these sources. But on this side, we expect you to have some sort of a framework where these three aspects of taxonomies could potentially be stored, they could be harmonized and all that. And you should have certain, let us say, frameworks again, where those algorithms can be trained to, let us say, auto sort of map the physical data elements to these business terms. That's one. Okay, so that framework is like one of the key things which we are looking at, right? Now, once you pass that, so you cleared one tier, which is looking at the metadata, right? Augmenting it with you know, the business vocabulary associations, right? And, you know, probably you might use some human intervention, and we expect that to be the least extent to maybe look at outliers which have not gotten mapped, and maybe you kind of do that mapping. And, you know, the repo is all done. So now you have a good trace of what is the source, what is the physical data element, and what that essentially means within a particular company, right? So that is one journey. The other piece, what we're also looking at, is there are things, you know, which you might have done in your past life where you look at a particular source and you run some analytics, right, on the data itself, right? So wherein you basically look at a particular column, right? Let us say the column has got something called as CC underscore NO. Let's just assume CC underscore NO for now, right? And assuming that you solved the previous problem where you identified that CC underscore NO is credit card number, right? You could potentially have frameworks which could look at a particular data set and look at that particular column, entire column. And let's assume that somewhere in that column, you found some data, which is A underscore something, right? Which is numeric and whatever. So you know certainly that that is not a credit card number, right? Which means it is an outlier again. Now, there are also scenarios where you could potentially find the first four digits, you know, being non-existent in any of the credit card series, right?
Yeah.
So in... So what is typically done is the data analysis part now kicks in here. So there are certain data or information analysis rules or data quality rules which can be put on data sets, which can give you things like, you know, anonymous values, you know, in that data set, null values in the data set.
Yeah.
Values which are probably outside, let us say, the domain range. Now, when I say domain range, that domain range could be credit cards, that domain range could be latitude, longitude, it could be city, state, country, you know, whatever that is. So we are not saying that you need to solve the whole problem. Mm-hmm. Basically saying is that if you have a framework which can, you know, pick, let us say, a set of KPIs around these data analysis issues, that framework is extensible, right? And then you can show some results saying that, okay, I looked at this data set. Here were the 10 aberrations. Here are the null values. Here are anonymous values. Here are domain violations, etc. So we are just looking at, you know, this part of the problem. So this is like the first mile problem when you hit on any client data ecosystem, understanding that ecosystem. So that's exactly what we're trying to get at, to see what you can do in these two journey miles. Again, in summary, first one is it's all about data discovery. So the data discovery basically entails you discovering the metadata and then trying to associate business vocabularies with that so that the business meaning of that data is also understood, right? And second is the understand of the business meaning also has an extrapolation to that, wherein it gives you a hint of the domain range, and that will in turn help you in analyzing the data at its semantic level and the syntactic level as well.
Got it.
Throw up some KPI. So that's exactly what we're looking at. Yeah.
Okay. So I'm sure you had time to look at our PowerPoint slides that we had sent across. Do you want me to spend 5 minutes giving you a little more view about what we do?
So we'll do one thing, Iqbal. Please work with the Incubate Hub team to set up time with me separately, either on 30th or 31st of October. Okay. So let's start in that meeting, right? So, and if you're okay, maybe we can potentially look at a demo as well, if you're open to show that.
Okay. So what would you like to see in the demo? Because what you're talking about, the work that we do in bringing the data together, the integrations that we have built with various source systems, all that is code at the end of the day.
Yeah.
Some of the data management or data prep workflows we do have, but those workflows are built for, you know, data stewards, if I may use the word. So like some people say, all that is great, the code is great, but I also want to upload a file once in a while. So I want a workflow. So we have some of those workflows, but a lot of our AI work is in code at the end of the day, all the algorithms. So we can show you some demonstrations. We can show you, we can have some, you know, white papers that are about the algorithms we use for, say, ID resolution and other stuff. But what exactly do you want to look at from the demo?
Yeah, so as I described, there are two journey maps which we are specifically interested in, right? Mm-hmm. So one is the aspect of data discovery, which to explain to you, I think in all possible detail, which I can do now. And the second is the data analysis piece, right? Where information analysis happens. Now the AI piece kicks in, you know, in the sweet spot, one particular sweet spot where we are looking at, you know, the phrase I use, the automagical mapping of the data elements to the business steps, right? So that is where, you know, we are looking at obviously the kind of strength you have in your algorithms and all that. But net, right? As a part of this particular challenge, see what we are basically looking at is primarily three things when you showcase the you know, end state of the meetup of the challenge, right? Wherein we are looking at number one, what is it that, you know, differentiates you from others and all of that, like an elevator pitch, right? So that's one thing what we're looking at. I mean, I don't expect you guys to do me a marketing presentation or whatever, general, you know, simple statement of facts, I think is fine. So obviously, we are looking at, you know, what does your technical architecture look like? What does your tech stack look like? What are the kind of frameworks you have in play? What kind of CSPs you support, you know, or you intend to support, etc. And just give us a sense of what that whole technical architecture looks like. And I think, yeah, finally, I think what we would also want to look at is the core sort of, let us say, differentiators you have built. And yeah, if there is a good pivot on the amount of coding you've done, yeah, maybe some of us will potentially set up a separate time with you to go over, you know, some of the code you may have written just to see how things are, you know, whatever. So it really depends. But I think, yeah, these are the three key things we would be looking at, right? Sure. So yeah, the elevator pitch, your technical architecture, and differentiators, three main things. Yeah.
Okay. That's helpful.
Iqbal, you represent which team? Sorry, I joined in late.
I'm the co-founder of Xylotech. We are a customer data platform. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. So I do see that there are a few others who joined the call.
They are also from the same team, Bhavani. So they are from Xylotech itself.
Okay. Okay.
So Sandeep joined the call from our team.
Yeah, so I was sort of, you know, somehow magically, maybe because of some sort of AI, the invite that I received was somehow canceled. So it didn't reflect in my calendar, but now that we are in the call, it seems that it's going on. So yeah, so I joined a bit late, but I think we got the gist of what you need.
Mm-hmm.
So we're looking forward to sort of see how it goes from here.
Yeah. I think, I've given up pretty much of the explanations to Iqbal, Sandeep, already. Is anything you wanted to check on or sure? I'm more than happy to take those questions now.
I think you explained it well, like two core things that you're looking for. One is some sophisticated way of schema mapping, and another is about how we implement frameworks on a particular field. So I think I get this sense of what you're looking for, and hopefully, you know, we can sit together with Iqbal and our technical team here and figure out like, if we can somehow, in a very simplistic manner, you know, try to present you what you are looking for in our next meeting. So, yeah.
Yeah, sure. And I hope you appreciate where this is coming from, because I think, see, in your experiences with clients, you would have already seen this, right? So the moment you sign up a deal and you go into the discovery phase, right, you will spend hours and hours setting up meetings, talking to the right people, figuring out which data is where, and, you know, all of that, right? So the point we're trying to get at here is that, you know, just tell us your data sources, give us the connector credentials, and, you know, we'll take it from there, kind of a thing. So that's the story you would want to paint, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that's the elevator pitch for you.
Yes. Thank you.
All right. So, yeah. So if there are no other questions, then maybe we can adjourn this meeting.
Yes. So we will set up a meeting on 30th or 31st.
Yeah. 30th or 31st. Yeah. I mean, I'm available tonight, so no problems with that. Anytime you guys are available and my calendar is open, I think you can roll with maybe 30 minutes or 40 minutes.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks for your time. Have a good evening.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, everyone.
Okay.
Thanks. Bye.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Hey, Bhavani, this is Abhijit. Do you have a minute?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, hi. That's my initial show up over there.
Yeah, so, that's what I was wondering.
We also got a call saying that. We also got a call saying that the meeting had been cancelled, and then we were actually moving from one meeting to another. That's when I accidentally clicked the link.
Oh, okay.
Call. So I was not sure.
I was not sure. No, I think the way this, I'll tell you, Abhijit, the way this played out was that I think there was an ask where there was like a one-on-one sort of webinars which the teams were sort of expecting. That is, Pradeep had WhatsApped that to me, and I had basically told him that today might be a short notice. You know, given that I just came back from business travel yesterday, and then, you know, festivals and all that coming up. So I'll make myself available between 30th and 31st. So that's what I told him. But I did tell him that let's hold a slot today, just in case somebody accidentally joins. You know, if we can close out some Q&A today, then might as well do that. So that's where I think the little bit of confusion happened. So sorry about that.
It was quite a nice serendipitous click on the button, I would say. But this is good. I actually caught about 5 minutes of the instructions or the guidance that you were giving to Iqbal.
Okay. So that helps. Okay.
I just wanted to know, how do I go about blocking some time from you? I think the stage that we are at, we also not need more than 20 to 30 minutes. I'll tell you where the problem is in our mind. Mm-hmm. We're told that, hey, you progress with whatever solution you gave.
Mm-hmm.
But then it doesn't, we don't know whether from your perspective, from an evaluator's perspective, where does that solution fit in?
Mm-hmm.
Did you guys go through the slides in detail and you're okay with us proceeding on those lines? Or do you have any guidance in terms of do's and don'ts? So just if you don't mind, a little bit about the timelines and when would you want us to actually do a demo or a pitch, whatever you call it, because we don't have a date at this point. What would do you think we should sync up again just to bounce off things, say this is where we are, and how close to the demo days will that be? I know 30th and 31st are probably good dates for you, but otherwise, what would you suggest?
I think the point we are at right now, and I'll give you some ballparks here, right? We are looking at least closing out on all the reviews and all that by the 10th of November, right? Thanks to participants asking us more time, even at the submission stage and all that, we've kind of been a little flexible in moving the dates around a little, right? So the short answer to you is the catch-up piece which you were on. Right. So I'm going to keep my calendar open on 30th and 31st for all the back-to-back one-on-one slots, which Pradeep talked to me about. Right. So we can certainly have this discussion on 30th or 31st. Right. Now from the expectations, as far as the demo, et cetera, is concerned, I think I was explaining to Iqbal also a little more in detail. So I'll just probably repeat that for a bit. See, what we are basically looking at is basically two journeys, right? One journey is that, okay, you've got a connector. The spread of that connector in terms of the types is your lookout. So whether you want to go from our DBMS to dimensional models to JSON stores, etc., or object stores for that matter, how much you want to spread that is your lookout. But once you have the connector, the journey from there on how you basically, I would say, extract the metadata out of that particular data store or the set of metadata. It could be tables and all that, right? Extract the metadata, catalog it, and ensure that there is a process defined in the first place to associate terms with that. So the glossary piece is open at this point, because like I said, it can be some open source component or something of that sort. We don't expect you to code that. But what we are looking at is that if the glossary repository is available, how can you kind of really use AI/ML to map the data elements to the glossary elements? So that's the first journey map, right? Now, second journey map, obviously, is all the information analysis piece, I think, which you probably heard already. So what we are looking at is, again, the part of the elevator pitch, I already spilled the beans on that. So I think the elevator pitch is what we are looking at. Which is the what part of it, right? And the how part of it is we will basically look at, what does your technical architecture look like? And so some aspects of your presentation around that area would help, because we would like to, first appreciate the fact that as much as open source being used is good for us, right, and everybody else. Second is that the spread of deployment, right? Whether it can go all the way from on-premise systems to cloud service providers, etc. So I think that is what we would look at. And finally, what we would look at is some aspects of differentiators. And the differentiators would potentially be an important piece, because that will also show us, how much you looked at the market, as to what the competition is doing, and how you try to pick a sweet spot where you can fit in well and maybe, kill competition, etc. So I think that's sort of the areas we're looking at.
Great. That's very helpful. Thank you.
Yeah.
And so the final presentation would be like in person. How do you guys expect that to be?
Yeah, we'll have that communication done to you. So the review presentation, right? The review presentation for rating your submission for the final round obviously will be remote. There could be a scenario where we might make arrangements for in person, but the challenge we have is our panel is geographically spread out. Okay. So it might be a bit of a challenge to do things in person. But yeah, I think what we may want to look at is at a moment anchor it saying it's going to be remote and then let's take it from there.
Got it. Thanks so much. And I think I extended the call by a few minutes. So
No, that's okay. This is important. We have to get all the questions answered. Yeah.
Great. I'm done for now, Bhavani. So I'll work with Vijay. Okay. I think.
So Abhijit, I think, sir, now your one-on-one kind of request is also kind of fulfilled now here. You wanted a time with Bhavani.
Yeah, I think he's also looking at another slot. So let's kind of have that booked, on 30th or 30th.
Is that for demo or one more mentoring session itself?
So I think
it would be a Q&A. From my side, that's not necessarily a demo unless Bhavani wants specific areas to for a deep dive. I'd be happy to share.
So
mostly Q&A from my side.
So the demo schedules will be published, right? So I think we can hold that demo slot separate, Vijeta. But this one I think is more of a Q&A. And thanks for that.
Thank you so much, Bhavani. Thanks.
Vijeta. All right. Sure. Absolutely. Pleasure.
Really appreciate your time.
Pleasure. Okay. All right. So I think we can adjourn the meeting now, I guess.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. All right. Thanks, everyone. Talk to you. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, Bhavani, for all your extended support and thank you for taking out time in this busy schedule. We really
appreciate it. Absolutely. No problem. Absolutely. Thank you. Yeah.
Thanks. Bye.